What you know about rolling down in the deep?
Please pause for a moment of silent reflection. Do you have a drawing or painting you'd like to be featured on the Moment of Silence? Visit wbmsvideo.com/Mozart to submit your work. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the Republic
for which it stands,
one nation, under God,
indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
The human brain is an amazing thing. It processes an incredible 400 billion bits of information a second, interpreting the world around us so we can see, hear, taste, touch, and smell. Most of us have what's called a neurotypical brain. This means we process information the same way most people do. But a small percentage of the world's population processes information in a different way. They have an autistic brain, which affects how they perceive the world and communicate with others. Maybe you know somebody with autism. That doesn't mean you know everything about autism. Autism isn't an illness or disease. It's a collection of related neurological conditions, which manifest differently for each person. This is why it's called a spectrum. Every person with autism has their own unique characteristics and behaviors, which means they may react to their environment in a totally different way to someone else with autism. One autistic person might not be able to speak, but can solve complex math equations. Another might paint beautiful pictures, but struggle to cope with bright lights and loud noises. The autism spectrum affects people across 7 different areas, including social skills, which affects their ability to interact with people in the world around them, language skills, which impacts on their ability to understand what others say to them, read body language and facial expressions, or make eye contact. Information processing, which makes adapting to new environments or routines a challenge. Sensory processing, which makes them over or undersensitive to their surroundings. Behavioral and emotional skills, making emotional regulation difficult. Sometimes people say we're all a little autistic, but this isn't true. Autism affects people their whole lives and can make it hard to deal with the world. An autistic person has to come up with coping mechanisms a neurotypical person doesn't have to worry about. Autistic people who can talk and have reasonable physical coordination are often described as high functioning. Yet they often have problems with getting jobs, making friends, having romantic relationships, or organizing their lives. If you meet someone with autism, instead of trying to change them, try asking about their lives and what autism has meant to them. You never know. You might learn something really cool.
Alfreda Color Guard is hosting an experience camp April 29th from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. for interested 8th graders. No experience is necessary.
Campus Life is hosting a candy egg hunt Friday, April 14th at 8 a.m. in the recess courtyard. Come for fun and fellowship.
Congrats to the orchestra students who performed beautifully on the Fulton County Youth Orchestra concert Wednesday, March 29th. Bravo, students.
It's movie time. Chinese Club will meet in Ms. Hu's room 904 after school on Friday, April 14th. We will watch the Disney movie Turning Red.
Seventh graders, apply to be a web leader for next year. Applications are due April 12th at bit.ly/webl2023. Questions, ask a web coordinator, Ms. Anderson, Mr. Kaiser, Ms. Palace, Ms. Brez Bradica, and Ms. Barnhart.
Today for lunch we have General Tso's chicken with steamed rice, turkey and cheese croissant, teriyaki Morningstar nuggets with steamed rice, cheese croissant, assorted fruit mixes, assorted fresh fruit, signature side salad, and steamed broccoli.
Today's SAT word of the day is tenacious, an adjective. It means to be tough.
Well, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a great day, Jaguars. Miss an announcement? Subscribe to our YouTube channel and revisit announcements and more. Teachers, have an announcement? Email us at wbmsnews@fultonschools.org.